نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونسترشده ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن نبينا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. All praise is due to Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him and we love Him and we seek the help all in from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whomever Allah guide, no one misguide him, and whomever misguided, no one will guide him. I bear witness and I have a faith, there is no worthy to be worshipped except Allah Almighty alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness and testify that the last prophet is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. يقول الله تعالى في كتابه العزيز بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. O people, fear Allah, fear your Lord, the one He created you from a single soul, Adam. And He created from Adam his wife, Eve, a Hawa, our mother. And fear your Lord and give the right over the relative, the one you are related to, Al-Arham. Inna Allah kana alaykum raqiba. Indeed, Allah have a power watching over you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, one event happened in the time of our beloved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That event is so holy, it has a miracles. And Allah Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala named a surah, a chapter from Al-Quran with that event. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned it also in different verses and different surahs. To reflect our mind how important that event. It's a gift from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the special way to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also is a gift from Allah over all the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let's find out what this event, what is this gift, what sort of miracles, and what the Quranic verses mention about that event. This event, Allah named the surah, Surah Al-Isra. Allah says in the Holy Quran, بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنرياه من آياتنا، إنه هو السميع البصير. سبحان glory be Allah, praising Himself, Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. سبحان, the majesty belong to Him. سبحان الذي أسرى, glory be to Allah, the one He take a Prophet Muhammad, His own Prophet, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, took him a journey from Mecca all the way to Jerusalem, to Baytul Maqdis. ثالث أولى القبلتين وثالث الحرمين الشريفين. The first direction of Qibla over the Muslims, over the believer, and the third masjid in the levels, Masjid Al-Aqsa. So it's a gift from Allah, and miracles being given to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to take him a journey from Mecca all the way to Baytul Maqdis. Allahu Akbar, in one night is faster than airplane. What amazing miracles happened to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After severe and difficulties Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam faced after al-Bi'tha, after that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as a prophet, and before the hijrah, some of al-Mu'arrikhun, the one they take care about history, they say 1 year to 1.5 years before the hijrah of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was in his house, suddenly futihat taqi, suddenly a big window opened from the roof, and Jibreel alayhi salam came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to take him a journey, to take him from Mecca all the way to Medina with animal named al-Buraq. That animal is bigger than donkey and smaller than the horse. And that animal, white color and very fast, that the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ described the speed, that where is the end of his side, he put his foot. So as you can see, the first step, that animal can go. So it's very fast animal. The name of that animal, al-Buraq. Then Jibreel alayhi salam took Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam all the way to that journey until he arrived to Baytul Maqdis, to Jerusalem. And he tied that animal on the wall in Jerusalem, and he went inside the Masjid of Al-Aqsa, which is in Jerusalem. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he read the prayer over the list of Prophet of Almighty Allah subhanahu. This is happening. So what is the reasons? One of the reasons, as Allah mentioned in the Quran, لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا. So Allah wants to show Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam least of the miracles, least of ayat, least of signs, least of something from unseen world, which we will not able to see it in our naked eyes. As a gift to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As a Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the seal of all the Prophets. Then, what happened after that? In Sahih Muslim, عن Anas bin Malik رضي الله عنها عنه قال أتيت بالبراق وهو دابة أبيض طويل فوق الحمار ودون البغل يضع حافره عند منتهى طرفه. That he mentions that hadith authentic, which is a narration from Imam al-Bukhari, the narrator of Anas bin Malik. There is so much hadith talking about the journey of Isra al-Mi'raj. Some of the narration in just in the Sahih Muslim, more than 20 narration. And also Sahih Bukhari, and also a lot of hadith mention authentic about this event. So Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, حَتَّى أَتَيْتُ بَيْتَ الْمَقْدِسِ فَرَبَطْتُهُ بِالْحَلَقَةِ الَّتِي يَرْبِطُ بِهَا الْأَنْبِيَاءِ أو يربط به الأنبياء ثم دخلت المسجد فصليت فيه ركعتين. So he described Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم that journey, that I went to that masjid in Al-Aqsa and I tied the animal and I prayed to rak'ah, leading the salah over the Prophet Muhammad, the least of prophets. And hadith Abu Hurairah قال وقد رأيتني في جماعة من الأنبياء فحالت الصلاة فأممتهم. I was between these of prophets of Allah and the salat comes, so I lead the prayer sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So one of the amazing miracles that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was able to see the other prophet, the previous prophets, ulul azm, by the naked eyes, and other prophets. So in the hadith that رأيت إبراهيم فإذا أقرب من رمن رأيت به شبها شبه صاحبكم به شبها لصاحبكم which is mean that the Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saw a Prophet Ibrahim and he described him that he really the most looked like the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And he is the father of all prophets. So Prophet Ibrahim looked like a Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And also he saw Musa Alayhi Salam, Mudharibun, Rajul Rasi, Adam, طوال ضرب من الرجال وكأنه من رجال شنوءة. Also he saw Musa عليه السلام and he described him, he was a big and tall a prophet of Allah and his color is not too white and not too dark. And he was a tall and big Musa عليه السلام and he described him as a tribes of شنوءة. Those tribes very tall and very big, huge body. وعن عيسى ربعة صبت الرأس أحمر أقرب من رأيت به شبها عروة بن مسعود. Then he described Isa عليه السلام, Jesus Christ, as according to the narration, he saw him in the second heaven. The first heaven, Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, he, Jibreel عليه السلام, after he prayed in the Jerusalem, he took him and up to the heaven. And he went to the first heaven and he knocked the door, Jibreel alayhi salam, and they asked who? He said, I am Jibreel and with me Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the guard from Malaika opened the gate of the first heaven and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered the first heaven and he saw Adam alayhi salam. In one narration that he saw Adam alayhi salam looking to the right, he see his ummah or his children or his descendants, they are among of the people of Jannah, and he looked in the left, he saw the descendants of Adam alayhi salam, they are not in the black, very long, like sawad, but so much, so many people from the descendants of Adam, in the left side, they are from among of the people of hellfire, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. Then he went to the second heaven. He saw Isa alayhi salam and Yahya alayhi salam. Jesus and the Prophet John, Yahya alayhi salam, Muhumma ibn al-Khala. They are related to each other. Ibn al-Khala, the son of the auntie, radiallahu alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be blessing upon all the Prophet of Allah. Then he went to the third heaven and fourth and fifth, and he saw this prophet, he saw Yusuf alayhi salam, and he described him, he been given the half of the beauty, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And also he saw Musa alayhi salam, as we mentioned, he saw Ibrahim alayhi salam, and he also saw Idris alayhi salam in the fourth heaven. And Allah says in the Quran, وَرَفَعْنَاهُ مَكَانًا عَلِيًّا, and we raised him up in high level. So Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw his beloved, a prophet. And every time they welcome Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with a beautiful word, amazing word, الرجل الصالح والنبي الصالح, or the son, the righteous son and the righteous prophet. All the prophet welcome Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They say, مرحبا, welcome, بالابن الصالح, that righteous son, والنبي الصالح, and righteous prophet, Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then he went after the seven heavens. And this is very unique. Things happened to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Until he reached a tree and a place called Sidratul Muntaha. Sidratul al-Muntaha. And he described that tree is so big and so huge that the shape of that tree is 100 years long. Allahu Akbar. How huge that tree. And the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went up. After that, he spoke to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Almighty Allah gave a Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam amazing obligatory, amazing fard, amazing wajib, amazing commands that this ummah is supposed to do a ibadah, worship, 50 salah a day, 50 prayer a day. So Prophet Muhammad received the order from Allah. Then he went back all the way down until he saw Musa. In narration Bukhari, he met him in the sixth heaven, in other narration in the seven heavens. Okay, so the most important that we know that he met Musa alayhi salam, Moses, and he spoke to Moses. He said, what did Allah or your Lord order you? He said, he ordered me 50 prayer. Then he said, go back to your Lord, fas'alhu takhfif, seek to lessen. فَإِنَّ أُمَّتَكَ لَا تَطِيقُ. Your ummah will not have ability that to do this one is so heavy. Then Rasul he went back to Allah and seeking to make it easier and less. In some of the hadith, he went, every time he go back, he reduced, Allah reduced 10, until he received the order 5 prayer. Then Prophet Muhammad on the way back, Musa stopped him again. He said, go to your Lord and seek to become a less. He said, فَاسْتَحْيَيْتُ. I feel shame, I feel shy, I cannot go anymore to Allah to reduce. I accepted. Then the time when he said, I accepted, he hear a call from heaven that it will be, it's a 50 prayer obligatory with the reward, it's a 5 prayer obligatory with the reward of 50 prayer. Can you imagine how Allah loved this ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? How much Allah made easy upon us that we pray only 5 times and we receive the reward as a 50 prayer a day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the only obligatory ibadah that directly been given to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam without Jibreel, direct from Allah to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To understand the value and the virtue of the salah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us understand. لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا إِنَّهُ وَالسَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. In another surah, surah al-Najm. وَالنَّجْمِ إِذَا هَوَى مَا ضَلَّ صَاحِبُكُمْ وَمَا هَوَى وَمَا يَنطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى عَلَّمَهُ شَدِيدُ الْقُوَى ذُو مِرَّةٍ فَاسْتَوَى وَهُوَ بِالْأُفُقِ الْأَعْلَى ثُمَّ دَنَا فَتَدَلَّى فَكَانَ قَابَ قَوْسَيْنِ أَوْ أَدْنَى فَأَوْحَى إِلَى عَبْدِهِ مَا أَوْحَى. This ayat talking about the journey of Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam al-Mi'raj, because Isra means journey from Mecca to Jerusalem in the land. And Mi'raj, journey from Jerusalem up to the seven heaven with the Prophet Muhammad. And it was a journey with the body and spirit. Not think like only the spirit or dream. No, it was a reality as a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers and sisters in Islam, try to understand the value and the virtue of salah. Also, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he saw ayat Azim, he saw Jibreel alayhi salam as he looked like, as an angel. 600 wings. Allahu Akbar. 600 wings. If he opened 2 wings, he will close from the east all the way to the west. Just one wing, it can close that distance. How about 600 wings? What a great creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Jibreel alayhi salam. Also, he saw Jannah, he saw paradise. According to the hadith, muttafaqun alayhi wa yatim Imam Bukhari al-Muslim qala, فَإِذَا فِيهَا حَبَائِلُ اللُّقُلُقُ وَإِذَا تُرَابُهَا الْمِسْكُ. That Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he entered paradise and he see it by the naked eyes and he saw al-lu'luq. What does mean al-lu'luq? Mean pearls. He saw the pearls in the paradise, and he saw the sand of paradise made out white musk. What an amazing, beautiful smell of sand. It's not a sand like our sand. It's a white musk. And white musk, as you know, if you want to buy original like this, it costs hundreds of dollars like this. How about it's all the sand made out of that white musk? What an amazing beauty of Jannah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us that beauty. Also, in that amazing journey that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he been tested. That In that al-rihla al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, in the journey of Isra wal-Mi'raj, that Jibreel alayhi salam offered Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam two things, to select one of them. One, he offered him al-khamr wa offered him al-laban, the milk. So Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam choose the milk. فَقَالَ أُوْتِيْتَ الْفِطْرَةِ You've been given to you al-fitra. What does al-fitra mean? Nature belief. That everybody born in the nature believe that he believe there is a God or existence of God or the way Allah create us subhanahu wa ta'ala. So also Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam during this journey, one of the incidents that he saw beast of people being punished. Beast of people he saw in that journey being punished by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, riba, the one they eat the interest. He saw them being punished. Also the one they backbite and eating the flesh of other people, they being punished. Also people doing fornication and zina, also they being punished. He saw that things. And he warned our ummah to be careful and avoid these sins. And avoid all this haram. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us understand. So these things happen in the time of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also one of the miracle things that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that they opened his chest. They opened his chest and they took his heart and they brought a plate made of gold, and inside that plate full of wisdom, iman wa hikmah, faith and wisdom. It was inside that plate. And they washed the heart of Rasulullah al-Malaika with it, and they returned it back to his heart and they closed it. And Aisha anha, I saw the lines like a piece of hair that remain in the body of Rasulullah wasallam. As that Rasulullah being selected, that shaitan will not be able to touch his heart or harm him or whisper on him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أقول ما تسمعون وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ويا فوز المستغفرين استغفر الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونسترشده ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we seek the blessing from Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters Islam, this amazing event, Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj, this amazing journey, let us tell our kids and children about this beautiful, amazing miracles journey as a gift to Allah, to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to understand and try to understand the amazing level of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the sight of Allah. Allah loved Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Allah gave him this gift as an honor that he is a seed of all prophets. Also understand and share the information about the amazing, amazing, amazing ibadah of salah, the worship of prayer that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered it to Prophet Muhammad directly. So take care about the five daily prayer, the second pillars of Islam, wa iqam al-salah, establish the prayer. And Rasulullah said in the hadith, al-ahdu alladhi baynana wa baynahum al-salah, faman tarakaha faqad kafar. The agreement or the things between us and the disbeliever is a salah, a prayer. Whomever neglects the prayer or does not do the prayer, he will become as a disbeliever. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. Because the disbeliever, they doesn't pray, the believer, they pray. So a person neglect the prayer or doesn't pray, he might put himself in the side of the disbeliever. Salah is very valuable, very important, and it has a rules. So let's learn the fiqh of as-salah and let's understand the obligatory of salah, wa ahkam as-salah, and sunan as-salah, and the time of salah, wa shurut as-salah, the condition of salah, and do the salah, salah as the Rasul sallam said in the hadith, sallu kama ra'aytumuni yusalli, pray as you see me praying. So this is really, really important that every single Muslim, male or female, old or young, must learn about the virtue and the value of the prayer. Also, this journey of Isra and Mi'raj, it's mentioned in the Quran. Some people, they deny it because they try to use their logic. They say it doesn't make sense that how come Muhammad, he traveled in one night to Jerusalem and up to the heaven and returned back all the way in the one night. And this is also what the disbeliever make fun against Prophet Muhammad, saying, oh, how come a person can go journey that fast in one night? They deny it. Then Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they came to make Rasul, they try to show the people that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a liar. So they ask Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, describe for us Jerusalem. Then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described Jerusalem to them. They shout, that's true. Then they came to Allah Siddiq, look, your friends, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he claimed that he went all the way to Jerusalem and up to heaven and come back in one night. He said, I believe whatever he said, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even beyond that. Because I am a believer, I believe in miracles. So this is, we should believe in this one, and any people trying to attack the hadith of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or put the hadith of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not value, we just follow Quran but we don't look at the sunnah. No, sunnah and the Quran, they are together. Sunnah explain the Quran, but we have to look for the authentic hadith. That as the people of following the way of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, many mistakes that people claim that is the night of 27 of Rajab. Where I check all the book of Sirah, there is no any authentic narration that mention exact day that in Rajab. And the people, they make whatever, like this night is the night of Isra and Mi'raj, and they do celebration based on the books of Sirah. It does not exist in any authentic hadith exactly. What the ulama, in the past, they said it is for 1 year or 1.5 years before the migration of a Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Mecca to Medina. So for that purpose, we're not sure exactly when it happened, but we know approximately. And the beauty that we are not sure exactly when did that happen, that the beauty, because every single day of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam life, it's celebration. Every single day from the time of Rasulullah is celebration. Why? Because every day there is an event. For 23 years from the life of Prophet Muhammad, not even single day that passed without something. Hadith, event, battlefield, historical, all the life of Rasulullah full of events. And we are proud all the year to mention and share the life of Prophet Muhammad. So every day for us is a happy day. So that is one of the visualize some of the things that we have to adopt it as we live with the journey of the life of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahumma inna nas'aluka an tu'izz al-islam wa muslimin. Allahumma ahdina lima ikhtalafa fihi min al-haqq bi'idhnik. Allahumma irfa' rayatana wa'li maqamana waghfir dhunubana wa'adkhilna al-jannat wa'ajirna min al-niran. Allahumma a'inna 'ala al-muhafazati 'ala as-salah. Allahumma waffiqna ila ta'allum as-salah. Allahumma waffiqna ila as-salati fi al-masajid. Allahumma waffiqna ila al-ikhlas fi as-salawat. اللهم ارزقنا الخشوع في الصلوات اللهم علمنا أحكام الصلوات واجعلنا من عبادك المصلين المحافظين على الصلاة منهم من الذين هم على صلاتهم دائمون من الذين هم على صلاتهم يحافظون آمين آمين يا رب العالمين اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الذي إذا دعيت به أجبت وإذا سئلت به أعطيت أن تردنا إلى دينك ردا جميلا وأن تصلح بناتنا وأولادنا وأنفسنا وتعيدنا من الشيطان الرجيم وتعيدنا من الأمراض تحفظنا جميعا من جميع الأمراض، وأن تفرج عنا الكروب، وأن ترزقنا، وأنت خير الرازقين. ربنا عليك توكلنا وإليك أنبنا وإليك المصير. ربنا لا تجعلنا فتنة الذين كفروا، واغفر لنا ربنا إنك أنت الغفور الرحيم. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون.